As you probably know, the CCO has changed the way specialty exams are administered. Everything's done on a computer. Doesn't matter if you're in a group testing, if you're doing testing at a test center, it doesn't matter. There's no pencil and paper exams anymore, and you can't use a pencil and paper to work out your problems. You can't use scratch paper to work out your problems. Because of this, it may be better to not draw out your problem when you're solving your load chart problems. This is another method. I call it the whiteboard method. This whiteboard method may be a little bit better for you to use on your exam than the other method where you draw everything out. You could still draw everything out. You still have the option of requesting a dry erase board to work out your problems, but this is another method. This is another option. And what you see on the screen in front of you is going to be very similar, or is very similar, to what you will see when you take your specialty exams, at least on the load chart problems portion of the specialty exams. You'll have the problem, you'll have the load chart on the screen, you'll have a whiteboard to do your work on, and you'll have a calculator that you can use. What I want to do in the remainder of this video is to work out a load chart problem for you, showing you the whiteboard method. And again, this whiteboard method, this is nothing new. I mean, there are some instructors that have recommended this approach for many, many years. I always like drawing it out because it gave you a visual of what your configuration was. I think you're less likely to leave something out when you do the diagram. But the diagram's not necessary, and this is a method where we're not going to use a diagram. Now, this is a problem that I have worked out previously, and there's a video of me working out this problem previously using the diagramming method. And at the end of this video, I'll provide a link to that video if you want to take a look at it also. That way you'll have the same problem worked out using each method. So, but let's go ahead and get started. And the same process applies whether you're using the whiteboard method or the diagramming method. The first step is to simply find out what the problem is asking for. In this example, they are looking for the maximum net capacity lifting off the main boom. So it's a net capacity problem. Once you identify what kind of problem it is, write out your formula. Net capacity equals gross capacity minus deductions. And what we're going to have on the whiteboard, if you haven't watched my other videos, I'll go ahead and give you a preview of what we're going to have on the whiteboard here that I'm using. We're going to have four sections. We're going to have the formula section. We're going to have the gross capacity section. We're going to have a section where we jot down some notes about the crane's configuration. And then we're going to have a section where we identify our deductions and total upper deductions. Again, first step, though, is writing out your formula. Next step is gross capacity, determining what your gross capacity is going to be. Gross capacity is going to be the lesser of your chart capacity or your line capacity. So we'll need to look up our chart capacity in the load chart for this configuration, and then we'll need to look at what the line pull or line capacity is for this configuration. And we'll come back to this in just a second. Let's go ahead and jot down a few notes about our configuration. We have 48-foot main boom. We have radius 20 feet. There is a hose reel on the boom. That's going to be a deduction. We have a 23-foot jib stowed. That's going to be a deduction also. Block, single shiv. I'm using SS to represent single shiv, two parts line, which the block's going to be a deduction. Then we have 13 pounds of rigging. So that pretty much, now we will need to refer to the this wire rope main information when we determine our line pull, which we can do that now. Let's go ahead and go back up to the gross capacity box and identify our gross capacity for this problem. And again, gross capacity is going to be the lower or lesser of chart capacity or line capacity. First of all, let's go to our load charts and find the capacity for 48 foot of main boom with a radius of 20 feet. And the charts for the TSS are really simple. That's it, you got one page there. We got 48 foot main boom. And we have a 20 foot radius. And where that column and that row intersect, that's our chart capacity. 8160 is our chart capacity. 8,160 pounds. Now we need to determine our line capacity. To find your line capacity for two parts line, single shib block, two parts line, we need to go to this table right here. That 37,000 pounds breaking strength, that is important. That means that 37,000 pound breaking strength, that tells us that we need to be in this row to find our line pull. We're in this row, we have two parts of line. So our line pull is 14,800. Again, this is important to pay attention to that, because there will be some problems where the line pull is going to be less than the chart capacity. If the line pull is less than the chart capacity, that's what you use for your gross capacity. In this example, chart is less than line, so we are going to use the chart capacity as our gross capacity. So we have NC equals 8,160 pounds minus our deductions, which we still need to find. And that's what we're ready to do now, is find our deduction weights. And let's create another box or another section for deductions. We have, just going back to our data table here, let's go ahead and start with hose reel. The deduction weights are found, most of our deduction weights are found on this page right here. The hose reel is a 190 pound deduction. The jib 23 foot stowed, now we need to find that deduction weight on the main chart. Okay. These are the deduction weights for the stowed jib. Deduction weights for stowed jib, and it's a different deduction weight for each main boom length. We have a 48 foot main boom. Again, main boom 48 feet, so our deduction weight is 260 pounds. Now, if our main boom had been 58 feet, our deduction would have been 220. Main boom of 26, deduction weight 480. So another thing to pay attention to. So 48 feet, 260 pounds. And we have a block, single shiv, two parts. Go back to this page. Single shiv load block. I can't spit it out of here. Single shiv load block 260. And we have rigging 13. Let's see. I think that should be it. Okay, one thing I need to point out here, and this is true for all TSS problems, there's no deduction for wire rope. No deduction for wire rope, which makes it great for you guys taking the test. You don't have to worry about a wire rope deduction. That's all. The weight of the wire rope is accounted for in the load charts. There's not a need to deduct the weight of the wire rope with the TSS charts. So, but let's go back. We have our hose reel, 190. We have our jib stowed, 260. We have our single shift block 260, and we have our rigging 13. That's it. Now we can total up these deductions. There we go. We have 190 plus 260 plus 260 plus 13 equals 723. And I'm going to double check myself because I might have mis-entered something, entered the wrong number. 190 for the hose reel plus 260 for the jib plus 260 for the block plus 13 for the rigging, 723. And we have everything we need now to find the net capacity. Net capacity equals 8160. 8160 minus 723, 7437. 7,437 pounds is our net capacity given this configuration. And that's it. Let me know if you have any questions.